IVM.
Hello and welcome to Smile India. I'm your host Shifa Maitra, and in each podcast I get you uplifting news from across India. News that's factual and provides respite from all the negativity you consume. So let's start with an amazing story from Mumbai. Yash Gandhi at 21 did extremely well at his CAT exams and is now studying at IIM Lucknow. What makes this journey extraordinary is that this determined student suffers from cerebral palsy and dyslexia. With an incredible set of parents who made sure he never felt different, Yash has been following his dreams. It's been far from easy given his disabilities, but he does rise every time he falls. So while he does need a scribe to write his exams, Yash, despite his limp, travels by local trains in the city. His speech is slurred, but he gets his emotions across. His zest for life lights up a room, and while numbers have always been a problem for him, he refused to give up. He spent 2 years preparing for his entrance exams and scored 92.5%. He got invitations from top-notch universities and is now excited about securing a position at one of the best institutes in India. That's a man to look out for. Now it's time for some nostalgia. Let me tell you about the young woman who was the first to get a job at Telco, which was a male bastion till then. In 1975, at the Indian Institute of Sciences in Bangalore, an ad was placed looking for bright young male engineers. A young female student felt affronted, so she decided to write a postcard to Mr. J.R.D. Tata, who was the chairman of the group at that point. She did not expect the job or even a reply, but she needed to make a point. She was shocked when 10 days later, she got a telegram asking her to appear for an interview in Pune and all expenses would be borne by the company. She went, and when the interviewers praised her academic performance, they still believed that women were supposed to do research and not be on the shop floor of a factory. She convinced them that she would be brilliant on the factory floor. The lady engineer was hired. She excelled at her work and met her future husband there as well. Today we know her as Mrs. Sudha Murthy. Isn't it delightful? So always remember to speak your truth. You never know where it could lead you. Time now to share some awesome news from the prestigious Udaipur Music Festival. One of the bands that stood out was a Sufi band called Out of the Box Jail University Band. This is not a trippy name. The performers are actually jail inmates who benefited from the Swaraj Jail University. Led by Manish Jain, a Harvard professor, this campusless university helps jailed inmates teach and learn based on their skills and abilities. The Art of Living organization was doing a course at the Udaipur Jail and realized that there are some very talented people in there. They approached Manish and then the jail superintendent. He liked the idea of inmates learning new things. Manish and his team then befriended the prisoners and found out who wanted to do what after they served their terms. Based on that, there are now different skill sets that can be honed. So within the jail, there is a music academy and a recording studio, a yoga center, multimedia and filmmaking course, art and painting courses, plus organic farming. For the music department, prominent musicians come and take guest lectures. The inmates are thrilled and feel like they're getting their dignity back. There is a salon where some inmates are learning how to get good at cutting hair. Coming up next is an architecture course. With the inmates having created over 40 murals on the walls, Rajasthan could soon have its largest open-air art gallery here. I believe this is real change worth appreciating. Given the strange times we are living in, everyone is super conscious about boosting their immunity. A young event planner who's been home like the rest of us was concerned about what she could do for her toddler. That's what Shiza Kazmi would talk about to her husband and friends. And soon she found herself researching products that are natural and beneficial. She reached out to farmers, got products, and was soon creating mixes and blends in her kitchen. Her husband Kapil Pandey, a media professional, and friend Bhavesh Bhatia, who's a food entrepreneur, jumped in and they spent the lockdown working very hard. Lakdong turmeric was sourced from Meghalaya and other spices like black pepper, cinnamon and dry ginger from authentic ethical farmers. Once the children approved of the taste, government sanctions were sought and now Rooted People is in business. You could have a mix with hot water or with milk and get your dose of immunity without sulking. What I find amazing is that at a time when people are worrying about their business going down, this trio has identified a need gap and started a totally desi business in the lockdown. And here's some more information on foods that will help you cope with your mood swings and anxiety that's afflicting a lot of us. Nutritionist Nayana Setalwad has offered these suggestions. Do not turn to junk food, sugary treats, and deep-fried food to feel better. I know that sounds tough, but that's what the doctors ordered. Make whole grains, bananas, nuts, and seeds your friends. Good quality desi ghee helps, as do sesame seeds, tulsi, and dried figs. A light early dinner and chamomile tea before sleeping will do the trick. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on IVM Network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on our social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, it's at Shifa Maitra on Instagram and Twitter. I will see you soon with a new episode of Smile India.
I hope you enjoyed that show. I'd like to thank our sponsors this week, Intel, for supporting us. First, right off the bat, want to congratulate Ashton Doctor on celebrating the 300th episode of The Habit Coach. It's a great show. If you haven't been listening to it, listen to it now. And if you listen to it, you can almost go for an entire year with an episode a day. It's really fun. Do definitely check that out. Arjun Koladi, the head of sales for Spotify in India, was on Advertising Is Dead. Do check that out. Really fun show. On Cyrus Says, we had Samit Basu, the author, fantasy author, one of my favorites. Definitely do check that out. It was Utsav Memoria Week this week on the IVM Network. He was on Cyrus Says Cock and Bull on Thursday. He was on Lit Nama and, of course, his own podcast, Postcards from Nowhere. Do check that out. And one last note before we go. IVM Likes is back, and we've been doing a bunch of interesting conversations about different pop culture things that you might want to check out during the pandemic. Do give it a listen. I'm sure you'll enjoy that. And with that, I hope to see you again next week.
Have you ever wondered how successful people do their thing? How do they navigate the challenges they often face? Are you wondering about the future of restaurants, film, education, technology, and everything else in between? Hi, I'm Gauri Devidayal, best known for being one of the brains behind The Table, an award-winning restaurant in Bombay. One thing my life as a restauranter has given me is the opportunity to meet with some truly inspiring people, most often just by chatting with strangers at the community table. And that's what this podcast is about. It's about learning the new dimensions of business and understanding how different people swim this sea. It's an opportunity for me to pick their brains and ask them all the questions on my mind, whether it's about learning from their past experiences or talking about future trends. Through their journeys, stories, and insights, I hope you too, like me, will come away inspired and energized. So come, join me every Wednesday with your favorite drink, because this round is on me.